All right, Western Virginia. I'm down here in Newport, North Carolina with my buddy Carl. He invited me down and actually got a softball tournament tomorrow in Kinston, North Carolina. So I came down a little early to see if we could find some stuff. I got a three ringer here that has been completely carved right off the top, which is pretty cool. But everything down here has got a very brown patina to it, so I'm not used to that. Where I live at, everything's kind of white patina, unless you're out in the swampy bog or whatever. I'm sorry, the wind's picking up big time. Anyway, that's pretty cool. I've never seen one completely carved off like that. But anyway, not a whole lot at all. I mean, this field has hardly got any type of trash in it at all. But man, it's got some pottery. Man, it's got black glass. I mean, I got a whole pocket full of pottery and glass. And a lot of camp lead, just small pieces of camp lead. But this field's been picked pretty clean anyway. Carl's, he's right over there. And you can see kind of what we're hunting here. So, I guess it's no big secret, it's Newport Barracks. But there's a lot of boot prints, a lot of holes. So, as Chad would say, welcome to North Carolina, because once somebody finds a spot, it's everybody digs it. So, anywho, thought we'd give it a try. I'd like to thank Carl for letting me come down. Hopefully, we'll get more video footage. But anyway, there it is right there. And that's the only thing worth filming. Thanks a lot, and have a good day. Hey, it's West Virginia. I just dug that car three ringer right over there, but this came up a good 74. It was about 6 inches deep right out of that hole right there. It's got the right patina on it. I just can't figure out what type of bullet it is. I mean, to be honest with you, the only thing that got me stumped is this little bit of, let me see the camera's not, there's a little bit of grooving right here. Definitely like a cavalry type bullet, maybe 32, 34, 36 caliber. The only thing I can see where the kind of the casing maybe went up right here. I've just not seen this type of bullet. So there, you can see it there. See that kind of grooving right there? I'm just not quite sure, so I'm going to need some help on this one. But I think it's Civil War. I mean, we're definitely in the spot. To me, got the patina on it. Sorry about the wind, guys. But I'm just not 100% sure if it's just after the Civil War, like 1870, 1868. So anyway, we'll have to do some research on this one. I think it's Civil War. I'm going to go with Civil War because I want to find Civil War. Because I'm telling you right now, this has been a lot of swinging with little reward. So, all right. I will say, I'm next to a sub power station, high power lines. This absolutely pounded spot. Three in a row for Civil War. It's right there. I haven't moved it yet, but it's sitting right there. I haven't even seen what kind of caliber it is. I just know it's a Civil War bullet. But I got the pinpointer on it, top of the hole. You know, it's 8 inches. All right, 8 inches every bit. And this could be a gardener, fellas. Nope, three ringer. Okay. What I had to do out here because of this power line. GM mode. Okay, I'm on tracking, so you can see it's tracking. Okay, but to get the depth, I buried a quarter at about 9 inches. I tried GM mode, factory preset, nothing, wouldn't even pick it up. Okay, so I was getting a lot of feedback. So what I did was sensitivity 92. My disc is at 6.0. I am in the 12 on the frequency. Iron volume 1. Okay, iron volume 1. Reactivity 1. Auto response 4. I notched out 93 to 99. And that right there gave me some depth. I started getting a good reading because there's a lot of like interference from these power lines, and there's a lot of surface iron and hot rocks. So that knocked all that out. And then I went to the silencer, and I'm at 0. I was at 3, and then I put it to 2, and I started getting it. And when I went to 0 and -1, I mean, sounded like just bing, 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 bing. So I knew, I said, all right, wow, I'm getting the depth now. I'm playing around with this dais still, but guys, regular GM, I measured it with my pinpointer. I dug a hole with my shovel, and I measured it from here to there, just like that. So I knew I had an 8-inch hole, and I put the quarter in, and I filled it back up, and I went over it, nothing. I messed around with the reactivity, I messed around with the notching, and then I went to silencer, and it sounded off perfect. I dug it out, I dug it all the way to the top of the shovel, which is about 10 inches, and I put the quarter back in, went back over, and bam. So I knew I was getting depth out here, and I was hoping that whoever's hunting out here is using like a T2 or a mine lab, where you're going to get a, well, mine lab, you can notch it out, but or silence it out, but you know, Fisher, Kinetics, anything like that's going to get a lot of feedback from these power lines and substations. But anyway, that was a deep bullet, 8.5 inches, silencer 0, still GM power mode, but I had to mess around with my settings. I was not getting anything 8 inches or lower with factory preset. So I was getting the feedback from the lines, getting a lot of erratic behavior, so that's what made me play with it. Luckily, I had a quarter in my pocket, and then I had a dime and a penny, and I did the same test, and no problem. So anyway, I hope that helps as we learn this machine and the power of this machine. It's not something you can do with every machine. Sometimes you're at the mercy of the factory presets. All right, well, there you go. Western Virginia, thanks a lot. All right, we're gonna do this live. Came out of this junky stuff over here, walked back up here, and just fire ants all in there. Whew, hold on 1 second. Kind of excited about this one. But anyway, I came in right here. You can see probably 7 inches. Popped it out, dug it out of this clump right here. It's in my hand. It's a button. It came up first, it hit like an 82 and then bounced down to a 68, and we're going to clean this one up together because this might be a great button. Definitely a two-piece. And it's an eagle button. You can see the eagle. I was hoping for a state button since this was Confederate and Union. Got one little nick in it. But definitely a Civil War eagle button. And there it is. In the back. Looks like the shank's there. All right, awesome. Deus is doing great. I'd like to thank Carl for letting me come down here and hunt with him. You know, like I said before, I got to be down here anyway to do some softball tomorrow with my girls. But, you know, I'm assistant coach for a team, so we're in a tournament. But anyway, there we go. Civil War, North Carolina. Thanks a lot. West Virginia. Hey, it's West Virginia again. The only thing I got since the last bullet was a piece of a J-hook, broken J-hook. But this came up 76 bouncing to 82 one way, 68 to 77 this way. You know, so just kind of, I mean, it hit, no question. It was a diggable signal, but just kind of it just couldn't figure quite out. But you can see in the bottom of the hole, it's another deep bullet. It's on the bullet right now, right next to it, and we're at the top of the hole. So another nine inch bullet, guys. I mean, you can see where it was into the wall right there. So, and there it is, another deep drop three ringer. Guys, this Deus is on fire. Kelly, if you're watching, you know, I gotta set you up with this program, girl. This getting on a pound at spot, this is deep. I'm getting some deep readings and they're coming in good. So thanks to my quarters and my penny and dime test, I would have never dug this stuff. All right, West Virginia, thanks for watching. All right, Western Virginia, 42 this way, 60 this way, out popped the button back. That was the first couple of scoops. That was probably 4 inches, 4.5 inches. And so I was thinking, wow, maybe the button's in there. And that was what the 60 was. You can see there was a bullet in there. Look how deep. 12 inches. The last scoop right here, the clump broke. It broke right here. Here's the other piece, and the bullet was basically sitting like that. I just cleaned it off. I looked at it, and the Deus hit it. It hit the button back first, but I was getting a squeaker the other way, the little higher pitch squeaker tone. So I stuck the pinpointer down and hole with sandy soil, just beautiful sand. I mean, it's just beautiful. And I stuck the pinpointer, was getting a faint hit, so I was digging it out nice and easy because I was hoping it was the top of this button, because that's going to be a two-piece cup button, probably a two-piece eagle button that broke. But I was trying to be careful, and that last little scoop, I just brung the shovel down and just brung it right out, landed it right here, and the bullet rolled out. I was very shocked. What can I say about the Deus? You know, this site is pounded. No secret about it. This is pounded. The landowner came up. Carl went over and spoke to him to thank him for allowing us to have permission. And the guy told him a couple years ago, he came out here to feed his chickens, which are right over here. And there was 50 people out here, guys. 50 people. Somebody had set up a organized hunt. Probably charged people $50, $100, whatever, and they didn't even have permission. Did not even have permission. I'm flabbergasted. If I would have had somebody on my land, 50 people on your land, think about the liability. Somebody could have got hit with fire ants, which there's a ton of them out here. Somebody could have fell, got hurt, you know, whatever, and they could sue them civilly. You know, the spouses might not even know their husbands or, you know, whatever, boyfriend, girlfriends are even out here. I just don't get it, guys. That's what gives us a bad name. That's what gives the metal detecting community a bad name. Dan, Bill, you know, the guys from Virginia, you know, everybody knows them, Fresno and Bill Dancy. Those guys do their homework. They present it to the owners, landowners, and they get excited. We do the same thing. Yes, this site is well known. No question about it. Anybody that lives down here knows about it. But Carl did his work. He searched the landowner. He knocked on doors, found the person, asked the person permission. You know, and the guy was he was just generous. I mean, I would never let anybody come back out. 50 people trespass on my property, I wouldn't let a metal detector guy near my farm. But we're professionals, Mid-Atlantic relic corn hunters. We're firefighters, police officers, bank managers, military, retired college. Guys, just do the right thing and ask permission. You know, I wish I would have walked over there, because I would apologize to the guy on behalf of the metal detecting community. I would apologize for the actions of others that can ruin our chances to come out here and have a good time. I'm saving history, guys. I got a button, bullets, pounded out spot, but I'm saving history. You know, this town, Newport, North Carolina, this is history. This is their history. You know, my history, my family fought for North Carolina. Okay, my family fought for North Carolina. So it's my history too. And this is just, it's a shame that that happened, but it's great that there's still people out there that believe if you do the right thing, you get rewarded. Didn't mean to get on a soapbox. Deus is kicking butt. Can't say anything bad about this machine. 9-inch coil. I can only imagine if I got the 11 or 13-inch coil. I'm having a good time. The weather's perfect. I think it's raining at my house. It's like 50 degrees and raining. My wife called and she was all like, you're down here in the 78 degrees and sunny. But anyway, I'm just very pleased with the Deus. 100 out spot. I'm finding stuff that people are missing. Thanks for watching. All right, well, yep. Knew it couldn't last. The wind is starting to switch and the temperature's dropping. Another bullet. But anyway, how good is the Deus? See this big piece of iron? Just came out of that hole. Flipped, and look what flipped out right underneath it. So pulled that out with this last shovel load. And right there, I thought it was iron too, because it looks like iron, but look, it's a pistol bullet. Yep, it came out right with it, same clump, just rolled off further down. So I got a 81 78 90, and that piece of iron was on top of it. So it went right through the iron and got the bullet. Cool. I love this Deus. I'm really, really, really loving the Deus. So just amazing me. All right, thanks a lot. All right.
Check this out.
There it is,
three
buddy.
Ringer. My three. First one.
First one. He
first
dug
one.
It. Right there.
Pulled it out of the clump off from the ground.
Yep, pulled it out of the clump ball right here.
Yep.
It was a F-19, right?
F-19.
Came up 71, 77, what was
77.
It? 77.
77.
There it is.
Three ringer, baby. Right there.
Awesome. Dude, I'm glad to be here to share that with you.
Thank you.
That's
Thank
awesome.
Thank you very much.
Yep.
My first three ringer right here.
See that?
First one. Right there.
All right, cool. Thanks for watching. Wes and Carl. See ya. Okay.